everybody, I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
And if adventure has a name, it's Armchair Directors. You know, I haven't worn this getup since we did the Crystal Skull review.
Yep.
And when I put it on, it fit like a glove.
There you go.
Just like Ford, it fit like a glove. Look, when we started this show, the two movies I wanted to discuss the most on this show were the original Star Wars films and the original Indiana Jones trilogy. We've done the Star Wars ones. This is my other dream show. Yep. Indiana Jones, finally on Blu-ray. He looks fantastic. The man with the hat is just in high definition glory. Fortune and glory.
Yeah, these movies have never looked better. They've gotten the special edition deluxe Blu-ray treatment. And we're starting off with the classic that introduced us to everyone's favorite archaeologist, Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Don't you mean Indiana Jones and the Raiders of the Lost? I refuse
to call
it that.
We won't touch it.
That's ridiculous. But yeah, Spielberg and Lucas one day, many, many years ago, decided they wanted to do an old serial. Lucas loves those old action serials, and they wanted to do a movie about a guy in a leather jacket with a whip and a fedora who was an archaeologist, and he was
just a great adventurer who traveled the world and found lost relics.
And Tom Selleck was unfortunately not available to play Indiana Jones, so they went with option B, Harrison Ford, made famous as Han Solo in Star Wars, and that was the best choice possible for Indy.
Mm-hmm.
Especially in Raiders. Indy in the other movies, he starts to get more lovable, more likable, sense of humor, but in Raiders, of apart from all the other movies, he's really kind of a scoundrel.
He is a scoundrel.
He's cutthroat. He's selfish. He's a pirate. And it is Raiders where he shows the least mercy, if I pun it.
And I do love that Indiana Jones is a great hero. He has these great adventures, and he doesn't hesitate to kill someone if he has to.
You know, the famous Cairo swordsman scene,
right,
which was, a lot of people know the behind-the-scenes story about that. Harrison Ford was very sick with food poisoning.
Yep.
So was everybody else on the crew except for George Lucas, who smartly didn't eat any of the local food. He was supposed to use the whip to retrieve the sword, and they just decided, why don't you just shoot him?
Yeah.
And a famous scene was born, which kind of carries over into Temple of Doom.
So if you haven't seen Raiders, the overall plot, if you haven't seen Raiders,
if you haven't seen Raiders, turn the show off
and go watch it right now.
You're not a movie fan.
Basically, you know, Hitler is on this quest to get all these occult things and supernatural stuff to gain power, and he wants the Ark of the Covenant. And Indiana Jones gets caught up and has to stop the Nazis from finding this great and powerful thing that may or may not be used for good or evil.
What's in this thing anyway?
Don't!
Just close your eyes. It'll be okay.
But fantastic casting. Obviously, Harrison Ford, so iconic as Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Just the look, the voice, everything.
Yeah, the deep voice.
But we get lots of great supporting characters in Raiders.
Yeah.
Marion Ravenwood is just a great, you know, combination with Indy, because she's also really tough. She doesn't take any of his crap.
She can do the damsel in distress, but she's also very sassy, and she keeps up with Ford. And I absolutely love John Rhys-Davies in this one.
Yeah, Sala is so good.
Yeah.
So,
and Marcus Brody also, Delholm Elliott.
Yeah.
Very small role in this one. It gets expanded later on in Last Crusade, but Marcus Brody is great in this one as well.
And the hallmark of the series, the action, the iconic opening sequence, still all these years later, just perfection.
Yeah.
Awesome choreography, great, exciting sequences that just make you want to stand up and cheer. They don't make movies like this anymore.
Nope.
And even when you try and make a movie like this, you just can't capture that lightning in a bottle. Yeah.
And there have been a lot of copycat attempts, other movies, King Solomon's Mines, mm-hmm, and Alan Quartermain and all those things. The most famous of the copycat indie movies or that type of character, I think, is the Tomb Raider games in the movies. Still, they don't hold a candle to Indiana Jones, because he's just got that iconic look that you see the silhouette of him, and it has such a presence. The hat, the whip, the gun, the jacket, even what Ford adds to the character, the stooped look.
Yeah.
It's iconic. It's, to me, when I think of an action hero, I think of Indiana Jones. He's the prototypical action
for sure
hero.
And these movies have fantastic music. John Williams, again, knocked it out of the park. That iconic theme. And just lots of really good recurring themes throughout the series. Really well done music. And even the way that these movies look, and of course Spielberg's touch, where like he likes to play with, you can just see someone's shadow menacing over people.
Yeah.
And there's lots of great shots like that in Raiders. just movie magic from start to finish.
I've mentioned before on the show how important it is to give us a proper first glimpse at a character. To not have him just be there, you know, to do a cut and there he is and there's your character, but to introduce him slowly and build him up to be larger than life. They do that with Brody and Jaws, which we just discussed. But
yeah,
perfect introduction for Harrison Ford. There are so many shots that Indy is in the beginning of the movie, but you don't see him until several shots later where you finally get that facial reveal.
Yeah.
And that happens with a lot of other characters in this movie too. So there's a lot of great classic filmmaking from Steven Spielberg. Fantastic editing. My one complaint about this movie is that it feels so long, and it's not that long.
Right.
A little over 2 hours, but he goes to so many different places around the world. It really starts to feel like I need a break to watch this movie in two or maybe even three sittings, because there's so much happening in like every little challenge he has. The whole Well of Souls thing is so condensed and compact. There's so much detail there, and I just love detail.
Yeah.
Detail aficionado. So I'm just exhausted after every single one of these big, elaborate set designs. And then the action is just so elaborate and choreographed and amazing that I start to just get numb to it after a while. And I don't want to be, so I take a break and then I pop it back in. So more than any of the other indie movies, this is the one that really takes the most out of you.
Yeah. And I just love to watch it start to finish, and I think it breezes by in about 95 minutes or so. So time for best part.
Worst part.
Go ahead.
Best part of this movie is when Indiana Jones is trying to retrieve the Ark from the Nazis. So he jumps on that white horse, catches up to the truck, takes over the truck, does a little fight with a Nazi on the truck. He gets thrown through the windshield. He's underneath. He's got the whip. He's being dragged. All these awesome old school stunts that they don't do anymore. Gets back on the truck. He's like smashing cars, and that sly, mischievous grin every time he does, you know, whoom. And then in a blink of an eye, it goes from fun to him getting shot. And now the stakes are high again.
Yeah.
When I think of sprawling adventure action scenes of all the movies I've ever seen in my life, that's the one. Yeah. That's the action scene that all others are measured by.
Mm-hmm.
Best part. Worst part. Worst part for all of the original Indiana Jones movies isn't going to be a nitpick. I really don't have any suggestions on how to fix them because I just love them so much. So my worst parts are going to be things that just make me go, ah, the Ark being open and Mr. Melty Face. Worst part.
I love Mr. Melty Face.
Well, you know, it's done exceptionally well, but it's just, that's the worst part of the movie. That's like turn away moment.
All right. Worst part, I don't even know. I love this movie from start to finish. It's really hard to find a worst part. Even watching it again when I saw it, you know, on Blu-ray and in IMAX, there's no part where I just cringe or anything like that, because even the effects still hold up pretty good.
The blue screen is okay in this one.
So I'm going to take a pass on that. And best part, again, I could just pick any scene of this movie, and it would almost work to be best part. I'm going to go really specific. When Indy and Marion meet back up, and the great scene where her bar burns down. It's just so cool. We get this great introduction of Marion. We get so much information about her and Indy's relationship. And then we get this really beautifully shot action sequence with lots of fire. And the villain is just really cool in that scene. So that's one of my favorite parts of Raiders for sure.
And it really illustrates to you what a walking storm Indiana Jones is. He just, things escalate very quickly or they fall apart. When it starts to fall apart, it really falls apart.
Big time.
Boots to Hearts is Indiana Jones's, you know, theme song. Because just within moments, this whole bar is devastated.
Yeah.
Which is what happens wherever Indy goes. So, a fantastic introduction to one of the most beloved movie characters ever. If you're a younger film viewer and you've never made the effort to see these movies, you've got to start. Even though Temple of Doom chronologically, for some reason, takes place before this, they decided it was a prequel, but you got to start with Raiders. It's amazing. It stands the test of time. It probably always will.
For sure. And we'll be back taking a look at Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.